Hello, welcome back to my channel, and a special welcome if you're new here. My name is Jen. I'm a certified weight loss and nutrition coach, and today we're talking about 10 easy, healthy things you can do in 2022. If you're going to make a resolution, if you've already made a resolution, these 10 things should fall on your list for 2022. So if you're excited, give this video a big thumbs up. Subscribe if you're not. I do upload every Tuesday and Thursday, so click the bell next to it so you never miss a single video. Check out that description box down below for nutrition coaching. I do offer personalized to you macros and calories. Let me help you reach your goals in 2022. And if you want to chat with me directly, I have one-on-one coaching as well. Links and discounts to all of my favorite things are also down in that description box. So let's start talking about 10 easy, healthy things you can do in 2022. Instead of setting yourself this huge, lofty weight loss goal for the year, what if you approached this year's resolutions or the things that you want to accomplish this year a little bit differently? Losing weight isn't the be-all, end-all for getting healthy. Having a huge weight loss goal can be daunting. It can also be unrealistic, and it can lead to unhealthy eating behaviors in the future. Eating a nutritious diet, again, is so much more than just weight loss. It can affect your life's longevity, your risk for chronic illnesses, and even your mood. Sure, you may even see weight loss doing these healthy things in 2022, but that shouldn't be your motivation. You'll likely have moments where the number on the scale doesn't even budge. And worse yet, you may have fluctuations. You may see that number on the scale go up. So instead of just focusing on that number on the scale, letting that little box that you step on once a week dictate your life, how about focusing on other facets of your health journey? How is this new healthy lifestyle making you feel? What physical changes are you seeing? What non-scale victories are happening for you? Maybe it's clearer skin, less bloating. Maybe you're a little more regular than you were before. If this sounds like something that may interest you, then stay tuned for the top 10 easy attainable health goals. Number one is honor your body's hunger and fullness cues. Don't wait for your body to become overly hungry where you're ravishing, and don't wait for your body to become overly full. You know, that whole Thanksgiving dinner feeling. The hunger scale goes from 1 to 10. Number 1 is absolutely starving, and 10 is overly full. Aim to stay between a 3 and a 7 when it comes to hunger. Wait to eat until you're truly hungry and stop eating when you're full. And remember, no food is off limits. Number 2 is eat the rainbow every single day. Who doesn't love an eye-catching, beautiful, colorful plate? Incorporating a variety of colors on your plate doesn't only look pretty, but it also ensures that you're getting in your vitamins, minerals, and nutrients from the foods that you're choosing. All of these different colors represent different antioxidants, phytochemicals, vitamins, minerals, and nutrients. All of this is needed to support a healthy body. The colors on your plate are generally broken up into 5 different categories: red, yellow, and orange, green, purple, and blue, and white. Well, it probably isn't realistic to eat every single one of these colors on your plate for every single meal. Try incorporating as many beautiful colors into your meals as possible. Number 3 is to schedule exercise into your everyday. We schedule work meetings, hair appointments, dinner dates. Why don't we schedule in activity? I'll exercise more. Sounds fantastic, but are you really going to do it? Is it something that you're going to stick with? By scheduling an intentional exercise into your day, you're more likely to not only do it in the short term, but stick with it long term. So make a goal to exercise on your calendar. And if something comes up, if life happens, you can reschedule that, just like you do those work meetings, hair appointments, and dinner dates. Set yourself a workout appointment 3 times a week. And this doesn't mean that you have to go to the gym and sweat for hours upon hours. Maybe you take a walk around your neighborhood. Maybe you walk laps in your house. Maybe you walk up and down your stairs. Just incorporate intentional activity 3 times a week. Number 4 is to increase your fiber intake. While it is recommended for women to eat 25 grams of fiber every day and men to eat at least 35 grams of fiber every day, the average American only consumes between 10 and 13 grams. Fiber helps feed the good gut bacteria, and soluble fiber can even help lower your cholesterol. 25 grams may sound like a lot, but there are some easy ways that you can incorporate fiber into your meals and snacks. Focus on fiber-rich foods like oatmeal, apple apples, sandwiches made with 100% whole grain bread, stir fry so you can get in all of those veggies, and even try it with half regular rice and half cauliflower rice. I promise you probably won't notice the difference. Number 5 is to include a fruit or vegetable at every single meal. Losing weight isn't about excluding foods or being in a severe calorie deficit. It's about eating a healthy, well-balanced diet that will not only help you lose weight, but will help you maintain that weight. The best way to eat less unhealthy food is to eat more of a healthy one. Instead of restricting or eliminating, it's really about incorporating healthy foods into your meals. Focus on a fruit or vegetable every single meal. This includes snacks. Add a cup of berries to your oatmeal or enjoy an omelet with spinach and cheese. Top your sandwich at lunch with avocado, tomatoes, and lettuce. At dinner, how about starting with a vegetable soup as kind of an appetizer or a precursor to dinner? And always enjoy a cooked vegetable of some sort alongside your main entree. These are easy ways to get in your fruits and vegetables. Speaking of fruits and vegetables, how about incorporating a vegetable every single day at breakfast? Make it your resolution to have a healthier breakfast every single day. Skip the bagels, the French toast, the waffles, the donuts, and focus on having a healthier, well-rounded, veggie-packed breakfast. Include a fiber-filled, antioxidant-rich, nutrient-dense vegetable with your breakfast. It's really easy to add a handful of spinach to some scrambled eggs. The spinach wilts down to pretty much nothing, and you cannot taste it when it's mixed in with your eggs. You can even add a slice of tomato to your favorite avocado toast. Another really fun idea is to stir grated zucchini into carby things like pancake batter or bread. They're onto something with zucchini bread. Zucchini adds moisture to baked things. And of course, a yogurt-based smoothie packed with fruit and vegetables. Again, throw in your spinach. You won't even taste it. Is a great way to incorporate those extra veggies. Number 7 is to try a new vegetable or fruit every single week. When you're at the grocery store, look around. See what's new. Maybe there is a fruit or vegetable that you've never tried. Maybe it's because you didn't know how to prepare it, or better yet, you didn't even know what that fruit or vegetable was. Try it, and then evaluate if it's something you want to keep in your rotation. Many of us have gotten very stuck in our ways when it comes to fruits or vegetables. We eat the same fruit and the same vegetable all the time. Try revisiting maybe some older fruits or vegetables you weren't a fan of and see if your taste buds have changed. Our taste buds are forever evolving. Same goes with vegetables. Maybe there was a vegetable as a kid you didn't like, but maybe as an adult, it may be a favorite. You can also try incorporating different cooking methods. Maybe that will help you like a vegetable even more than you didn't like it before. You may be pleasantly surprised when you find a new favorite fruit or vegetable. Number 8 is to sweeten your foods and your drinks naturally. If you want to skip or even limit the sugar that you're adding to foods and beverages, try using honey as a natural sugar alternative. Honey is very pure, it's very natural, and it has a wide array of vitamins and minerals. It also packs a big punch of amino acids and antioxidants. Just a pinch of honey can go a really long way for sweetening up your favorite foods and drinks. Number 9 is prioritize your gut health. About a year ago, I took the Thrive, which is now the OMBRE gut health test. I tested my gut. It came back with my results of what I was deficient in, and I was able to order a personalized to me probiotic. That has been a huge game changer. So much of a game changer that my husband also has his personalized probiotic in his arsenal of vitamins that he takes every day. I highly, highly recommend that gut health test to see where you're deficient and then supplement that with your personalized probiotic. I will go ahead and link it down below. They do have quite a big special going on right now. I will put all of the information of the Thrive/OMBRE gut health test in the description box. Our gut is connected to so many things. We are learning more and more every single day on what our healthy gut is connected to. Your digestion, your mood, and your immune system, just to name a few. Definitely try incorporating a probiotic into your routine. Again, highly recommend having a personalized to you probiotic from OMBRE. You can also add some additional fermented foods into your diet because those have naturally occurring probiotics. And just take some steps to be a little bit less stressed out overall, because that will play a big impact on your overall gut health. And number 10 is to focus on eating real whole foods. While packaged processed foods can be convenient when you're on the go, nothing beats a diet that is filled with real whole unprocessed foods. These are the foods that you generally find in the perimeter of your grocery store. Excessive consumption of fast food as well as processed and packaged food can play a big detriment in your overall health. Although okay in moderation, fast food and processed foods contribute to the risk of obesity, heart problems, and much, much more. Just focus on eating less. Less fast food, less processed foods. Doesn't mean that you have to eliminate them completely, because remember, no food is bad or good, but just focus your diet around whole, real food. That's everything that I have for you today. I hope that these 10 easy, doable resolutions for 2022, just for your health, will help you get off to the best foot possible in the new year. If you enjoyed today's video and you found it helpful, give it a huge thumbs up. Subscribe if you're not. I'd love to have you here. I do upload 2 days a week, so hit the subscribe button and click the bell right next to it so you never miss a single video. Don't forget to check out the description box down below for nutrition coaching, as well as one-on-one coaching if you're interested, and all of my favorite healthy things. I will also make sure that the OMBRE gut health test and any discount information is at the very top of the description box. Highly, highly recommend. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye.